Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is a privilege to welcome you all this evening to the Bishop School Camp as we prepare to witness the Bishop Junior College's production of Dynamic Mrs. Doubtfire. We have a wonderful evening in store for all of you with music, with a lot of comedy, and a lot of heart as well. Without further ado, may I please call upon our Honorable Principal, Mr. Joel Edwin, to lead us in a word of prayer. Sir?
Let us pray. Our Lord and Master, we thank and praise thee, Lord, for this wonderful occasion that you brought us all together. We thank you, Lord, for the efforts that have gone into put this production together, for Mrs. Mistry and her team, for all the children and choir, the cast, for Mr. Yogesh and his team of artists, along with the art department. We thank you for Mr. Johns and AJ, who've been assisting them in all the rehearsals over the past few weeks. Lord, we also thank you for all the support that have been rendered by our parents over the past few days. And we, Lord, seek that your blessings and your presence as we go into this evening's function. We thank you for the presence of our governing body members, for Mr. McPherson and Mr. Luke, our heads of the various institutions, and all our staff and students, along with our alumni who are present here this evening. Lord, we commit ourselves to your loving care, that you will be with each one of us, you will keep us, you will guide us and lead us. This we ask in thy precious name. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Junior College section of the Bishop School Camp proudly presents Dynamic Mrs. Doubtfire.
Bravo bravissimo, ah bravo figaro, bravo bravissimo. A te fortuna, a te fortuna, non mancherà. La 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 la. A te fortuna, a te fortuna, a te fortuna, non mancherà. Sono il facotum della città, sono il facotum della città, della città, della città, della città.
Salutation snack.
Yay! Und sie geht tot. Please, sie geht tot, please. ESP, ESPC. Mother, betrayen, kidnapped, no, burned. Eat my heart out, Meryl Streep.
A cup of garlic, a twist of parquet. Eat my heart out, Julia Child.
Excuse me, but isn't it customary for the jailbird to get one telephone call?
In your case, I think not. Afternoon snacks, a few civil liberties. But I'm not wholly without heart. How about a nice, soothing cigarette?
Oh, no! I will not do this! I cannot! No! Oh, the foul way for a bird to die! I don't want to get big cancer! No!
Oh, here we go again. God, roll that back. What are you doing, Daniel? That line is not in the script. Why did you add it?
I wanted to comment on the situation.
What situation?
Shoving a cigarette into Pudgy's mouth is morally irresponsible.
This is a cartoon, man, not an Oprah Winfrey special.
Lou, millions of kids watch this cartoon. It's like sending each one of them a carton of cigarettes.
You can't put words in Pudgy's mouth if his mouth isn't moving.
They're not words, it's not dialogue. It's an interior monologue. Maybe
even the voice of God.
Oh God, these actors, I tell you.
Okay, let's ask the technicians. Do you think it's morally right to promote smoking to the youth of America?
Yes.
Ah, they're biased. It's a mistrial. This session has cost the studio thousands. If you want a paycheck, stick to the script. If you want to play Gandhi, do it on somebody else's time.
Then I have got to do what I have got to do.
Huh, that's very funny. Where the hell are you going? If you leave, you're not coming back. I'm not taking any crap from you, pal.
Bye-bye.
Kids!
I thought you couldn't pick us up.
I got off early.
You mean you got fired?
Hey, I quit. For reasons of conscience.
Actors.
So, Chris, you excited for your birthday? The big one, too? I've got someone special coming to meet you.
Who? My girlfriend?
Oh, please.
Oh, nah. Wait, my girlfriend.
Ah, you wish.
A party?
Yes! No parties. Mom said you couldn't have one because of your report card.
Well, Mom's not going to be home for another 4 hours, is she?
Prepare yourself for the Wild Kingdom.
Happy birthday, Chris!
Let's get the party started!
Get the music going on!
Do you really want to know about the boy from the show? What you please. Miranda,
hello?
Sergeant Peppers has come to see you.
Yeah, send him in.
Miranda Hillard?
Yeah, that's me.
2640 Steiner Street. Is that your residence, ma'am?
Yes, I'm sorry to say it is.
Are you aware it's illegal to host wild parties at 4 in the afternoon in the vicinity of a children's hospital? They're all screaming like a bunch of idiots.
What if you're married to an idiot?
Ma'am, this is serious. We're responding to a noise violation.
Believe me, I'm going to respond myself. I'm so sorry about all of this, really.
Yeah.
What's up, girlfriend? Got a birthday party in the house.
What in God's name are you doing?
Listen, honey, you're just home a little early. I was gonna clean it up before you arrived, but I wouldn't go looking around if I were you.
Party's over. Out, all of you, now. Shut up. You three are grounded. Go to your room right now. You know, the cops called and they came to the office. They insulted the hell out of me because of your stupidity.
Wait. So the cops come to you and then you bust the party.
Don't you dare make me out to be the villain here, Daniel. Don't you dare. You get all the fun and I get whatever's left over.
Hey, you chose the career.
I didn't choose anything. I have no choices here. I tried to bring home a cake. I was going to bring home a few gifts. You bring home the goddamn San Diego Zoo.
It's a few party plates, Miranda. It's not toxic waste.
Well, why am I the only one?
We were going to clean it up.
Why am I the only one who thinks there has to be rules? Why do you always make me out to be some bad guy?
I don't. You do it yourself quite naturally.
Because you set me up.
Miranda, you spend too much time with those corporate clones you used to despise.
I spend too much time with you, Daniel. It's over.
What do you mean it's over, Miranda?
What do you think I mean?
I know we have our problems, but we can work them out.
We've been trying to work them out for 14 years.
Then why don't we see a family therapist? They could help us out, Miranda.
You honestly think it's not too late for that?
Then why don't we take a vacation with the kids as a family? It'll get you away from work for a while.
We take a vacation. We come back here. All our problems are right here waiting for us when we get back.
Well, then we'll move. And hopefully our problems won't follow us.
Don't joke, Daniel, please.
Miranda, look. We're different, okay?
We have nothing in common.
Oh, sure we do. We love each other, Miranda. We love each other, don't we?
I want a divorce.
Miranda! No! You can't do this!
We're no strangers to love. You know the rules, and so do I. A full commitment's what I'm thinking of. You wouldn't get this from any other guy. I just wanna tell you how I'm feeling. Gotta make you understand. Never gonna give you up. Never gonna let you down. Never gonna run around and desert you. Never gonna make you cry. Never gonna say goodbye. Never gonna tell a lie. I hurt you.
And as per usual, he is late.
Mr. and Mrs. Hillard, although these custody proceedings tend to favor the mother, we also realize, perhaps, now more than ever, that it is not in a child's best interest to deprive him or her of an obviously loving father. However, since at the present time, Mr. Hillard has no place to live and no employment, it is the court's ruling to award full custody to Mrs. Hillard.
No!
Thank you.
No.
Mr. Hillard will have visitation rights every Saturday.
Can't you do something about this?
He's made his decision.
Isn't it traditional to say I object or something? Your Honor, please, you have to understand. One day a week with my children, that's not enough. I have to be with them, Your Honor. It really isn't a question. I would do anything to be with my children, anything. You have to understand.
Mr. Hillard, this ruling is only temporary.
What?
Oh, good.
I will assign a court liaison to oversee your case. There will be a continuance of these proceedings in 90 days. Mr. Hillard, I'm giving you 3 months. 3 months in which to get a job, keep it, and create a suitable home. If this seems to be a possibility for you, I will consider a joint custody arrangement when we reconvene. We're adjourned.
Well, it looks like there is some light at the end of this tunnel. Well, that's all my stuff.
This is all my fault, Dad.
Oh, no, Chris, why would you say that?
I should have never had a birthday.
Oh, nonsense. You did nothing wrong, okay?
None of this would have ever happened.
You did nothing wrong. This was an accident waiting to happen. Okay, give me 5. You're the man of the house now, okay? Don't be messy.
You can't go now.
Honey, I have to.
But we're in the middle of an English project, Dad. Who's going to finish it?
Well, Grandma can finish it for you.
Oh, but she's not as good. She always skips parts and she never does the voices.
She smells funny too.
Oh, that's the formaldehyde. It's why Granny's so well preserved.
Oh, come here, kids. I'm gonna miss you.
We'll miss you too, Dad.
I hope Saturday comes quick.
Ditto.
Oh, Dad.
Oh, take care of her, okay?
Okay.
Miranda.
Stu.
Miranda, I've come by to look at your sketches.
Oh, of course. Please have a seat. So, as you probably know, the estate was built in 1876. These sketches are meant to reflect your desire to have it completely restored.
You know, Miranda, you look better than ever.
So, for the lobby, I was thinking inspiration from the French Second Empire. So, something like a music salon. How does that sound?
You know, I have been following your career these past couple of years.
Flemish tapestries, a big brass table, maybe even some curtains.
I'd love to get reacquainted, Miranda. Maybe catch up.
Mantel clocks, Flemish tapestries, fringed upholstered
chairs.
How
about we talk? Over dinner, maybe?
Stuart, thank you. I'm at the beginning of a divorce right now. It just didn't work out.
Oh, Miranda, I'm so sorry.
Oh, you don't have to say that.
No, really. I mean, I never really held any grudges or anything. Well, I always just hoped that you'd find happiness.
That's so nice.
Well, I was just worried my coming in here might scare you off the project.
No. I'm a professional and... You know, I was flattered. You thought of me after all these years and everything.
Yeah, everything.
Yeah.
College days really were fun, weren't they?
Well, they were good for something.
Well, ancient history.
Ancient history.
You know, wait, I have a meeting over at the bank to catch. I'm late.
Oh.
Can we talk maybe later in the week?
Of course.
Sure. It's good to see you again, Miranda.
You too.
I'll see you then.
See you.
Thank you.
Summer loving had me a blast.
Summer loving happened so fast.
I met a girl crazy for me.
Met a boy cute as can be.
Summer days drifting away to oh the summer nights.
Wella, 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 ah. Tell me more, did you get very far?
She got a cramp.
He ran by me, got my suit down.
I saved her life, she nearly drowned.
He showed up, splashing around.
Summer sun, something's begun. But oh, oh, the summer night.
Tell me more, was it love at first sight?
Tell me more, did she put up a fight?
It turned colder, that's where it ends.
So I told her we'd still be friends.
Then we made our true love vow.
Wonder what she's doing now.
Summer dreams ripped at the seems,
but
oh,
those summer nights.
What do you think of the new place?
Nice.
It's okay.
Detestable.
I know it's hard, guys. I'm not used to this new lifestyle.
Neither are we.
Why can't you just tell mommy you're sorry?
I'm wishing I could. Grown up problems, they're more complicated. Speaking of. How's the old battle axe? Your mother?
She's fine.
Oh, I'm glad to hear that. I'd hate to think she came down with a case of amoebic dysentery or piles.
What's amoebic dysentery?
An infection in your tummy. When you get diarrhea
forever. Diarrhea forever.
And your body dries up and you die.
You die? You don't have to be so graphic with her.
I read about it in a science book, Teddy.
Why would you want mommy to die?
Look, Dad, you're not trying very hard. We get to cover only once a week, and to be honest, that's not very much.
You're right. I'm sorry. I'll try hard.
And I'll
think about mommy.
I'll try. I really will.
I'd call her a princess.
Oh, yes. She's a beautiful princess. And, well, right now I feel like a big ugly toad.
That's Mom!
Hey, it can't be. She's early.
Come on, Natalie. We should go.
No.
Sit down, kids. You're on my time now, okay? You're my goddamn kids too. You don't have to go whenever she honks the horn.
Daniel?
Miranda?
This place is charming. Are my children ready yet?
No, Miranda. Our children are not here yet. You were late dropping them off, and now you're an hour early picking them up.
Daniel, look at me. Do I seem to have time to do this? I go. I have to go to the bank, then to the market, then I have to drop something off at the newspaper office.
Newspaper office? You're taking out on those personal ads?
If you must absolutely know, I'm placing out for a housekeeper.
Housekeeper? What do you need a housekeeper for?
Well, I need someone to be there with the kids, so I get home soon, clean, maybe start dinner.
My mom can't stay with us forever.
And how much will we pay in this housekeeper?
$300 a year. Is that all right with you?
And could I see the ad? I have a right as their father, okay? Please.
Fine. Anything else you want to see?
You are free.
Ah! Come on, let's just go, guys.
Listen, Miranda.
What?
Why don't you do me a favor? With the kids, man. With the kids. Let me pick them up after school. I'll take them home. I'll make sure they do their homework, eat dinner, everything. That would be great.
Please.
See, even the kids are on board.
About it. Mommy, please. Did I say yes? I said I would think about it.
We are his goddamn kids, too.
Oh, kids say the darndest things. I wouldn't know.
Any other choice phrases you'd like to teach our 10-year-old Daniel? Just come on. I'd say go to the bathroom before we leave, but looking at the living room, I wouldn't think that's too many. Come on, let's just go. Pack your coats, say goodbye to your car.
Don't forget this, Miranda.
Say goodbye. Come on. Bye, Dad.
Bye, kids. I'll see you next Saturday.
Oh, it would be my little light thing.
Monday to Saturday.
You
shouldn't.
Frankie, I need you to make me a woman.
What?
Miranda is hiring a nanny, and I put myself up for the job as an old lady.
What?
Frankie, please, I'm begging you.
Make me a woman, give it a shot. Go on and give me the best that you've got. I need help, and I'm coming to you, hoping you can work your magic on me. With imagination and calculation, you could turn me into your greatest creation. I'm ready, I'm in your hands. So take this man and make me a woman, if you can.
Unless, of course, this is beyond your abilities.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Oh, yes, he did.
To your face with a Maybelline base, rosy cheeks and ruby lips. I could do a do that could do good on you, amber streaks and golden tips. Lending the lashes, tidy the brows, wax the mustache, piss in a fabulous brush. The canvas is black, but the surface is rough. Woo, this is gonna be tough.
Make me a woman, give it a shot.
I'm gonna give you the best that I've got. Give me a moment, give me some room. I gotta do my magic on you. With imagination and calculation, I can turn you into my greatest creation.
I'm ready, I'm in your hands. So take this man and make me a woman, if you can.
There's a knife.
Oh. What's taking so long, Frankie?
The knife again. Where is it?
Jeez.
Ah.
Is this gonna hurt?
Don't whine, relax. Remember, pain, beauty is pain.
Oh, Frankie.
Okay. Take a deep breath. Instant dialer. Beautiful, fabulous.
Yeah, sure, Frankie, yeah, definitely.
The man has 5 o'clock shadow at 8:30 a.m.
Listen, I'm not gonna wax my face, okay?
Ha, don't you worry, we'll just lightly sparkle.
Hey, I hope you're using jungle red. That's the color I love.
It does match your lips. I think we'll have to do the entire face.
No way, Frankie.
Come on.
Starting to feel like Marilyn Monroe.
You look like her mother.
Oh, shut up, Frankie. You know, this is nice, but I think we need to go older.
Let's try this. Older, like Shelley Winters older, Shelley McLean older.
Well, what's the difference?
Some Scotch tape and red hair dye.
What about Joan Collins?
We'll think about it.
I don't know if I have the strength, though.
Go off. How do you look?
God, any closer and I'd be mom.
Of course you'd be mom.
Oh, shut up, Frankie.
Don't run.
And she's going to think we live like homeless people. Chris, put that thing away. I've told you multiple times. Give it here. Please, I know this is hard for you guys, but just try and be good. I know it's possible. And switch the TV off. That must be her. Please, be good.
Mrs. Hillard, I presume?
Yes, I'm Miranda Hillard.
Ah, you Virginia Doubtfire.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
You too, darling.
Please come in.
Oh, these must be the little cherubs.
Yes, this is Natalie.
Hello, Natalie.
Are you wearing box spray?
Natty!
Don't worry, it's quite all right. You see, I was a little liberal with the atomizer. At my age, everything has its own aroma. It's like a good Stilton. I admire that honesty, Natty. It's a noble quality. Never lose it. It often disappears with age or entering politics. Now, you know, Natty, you remind me of a character, the most honorable character in all of literature, Stuart Little.
Do you know that book, Stuart Little?
Yes, it's one of my favorites.
Mine too.
Oh, maybe I could read it to you someday. If I get the position.
That would be wonderful.
It would.
Oh, and who's this young lad?
This is Hello. Chris.
Jeez, Mrs. Doubtfire, you're big for a lady.
Chris! God, what happened
you could
to being
play,
good?
You could play for the 49ers.
Oh, in fact, you know, Chris, I did play football. Oh, but that's European football, dear.
Wait, Mrs. Doubtfire, you played soccer?
Oh, yes. Back in university, I used to play soccer. We won 3 university championships when I was captain. Oh, but that was a long time ago, dear. I was a good student back then, always putting my studies ahead of my athletics. I'm sure you do the same, Chris.
Well, not exactly.
Oh, you mean to say you haven't finished all your homework already?
No, not yet.
Oh, that's a pity. That's a pity, Chris. Young boys who don't complete their homework often miss out on more amusing activities.
Listening?
Oh, hello, and who's this young lady?
This is Lydia.
This isn't fair, Mom. Why do we need a housekeeper anyway?
And this is all I need.
Why can't Dad do it?
I don't think it's appropriate to argue with your mother in front of a stranger.
Thank you.
I just don't see why we can't spend the extra time with Dad.
Honey, it's not my fault. You know, if he'd just get a job and a decent apartment.
And maybe you should send the children out of the room before you verbally bash their own father.
You're right. I'm so sorry. Why don't you guys go upstairs?
Oh, it's lovely to meet you, Mrs.
You
Doubtfire.
You too, Christopher.
I'll see you later.
Oh, they're spirited bunch, aren't they?
Yes.
Gosh, especially Liddy. She's got daggers for ya.
Believe me, I know. They're very upset with me right now.
It's probably the divorce.
How did you know
that? Well, one can sense it, dear. The way she talks about her father. It's not like he's in the Navy or something. It's as if he's nearby.
Yes. Well, would you like a cup of tea?
Oh, tea, that would be wonderful, dear, certainly.
It's just through here.
Oh my! What a beautiful home you have, dear. It reeks of taste.
I designed it myself. Thank you.
Oh my! Oh, let me get that for you, dear.
Oh, are you sure?
Oh, I'm quite sure. Don't worry about it. You just go and sit down. You had a long day.
Thank you.
Tea.
Oh. Wow, you certainly know your way around the kitchen.
Oh, that's just because everything's so well organized. Everything has its place and name. I haven't been here before. Oh, I'm surprised there isn't a little label here that says spoons.
My husband never appreciated it.
Oh, poor dolt. That's not why you divorced him, is it?
Oh, no, no.
Just a moment, dear. I'll have your tea right there.
I know people say marriage can be a blessing, but so can divorce.
Well, I do believe marriage is a blessing.
And I believe divorce is. Huh. Daniel is a very difficult man to live with.
Ooh.
But the kids are crazy about him.
Ooh.
Yes, you don't have to be a psychic to see that.
Certainly not, dear. They're crazy for him.
It's very odd, but I feel like I know you from somewhere.
Oh, know me from somewhere? Oh, maybe we knew each other in another life.
Now, it must be it, because
must
I feel
be it,
like I've known
it.
You for years.
Oh, yes, dear, don't worry about it.
My point is, I would love if you could come and work for us.
Oh, dear, I would love to come work for you.
Amazing. To us.
To us.
To the start of a business relationship.
A business relationship.
I'll see you tomorrow, Mrs. Doubtfire.
You too, dear. Oh, oh.
Where are you going?
I think I just hello now.
You know, I painted a picture of a bunny. And the teacher liked it.
Oh, that's amazing, Natty. Oh, I love that painting. Oh, wonderful. Well, it's homework time, okay, children?
Yeah, but after Dick Van Dyke.
No, no TV. Now.
No, we always watch Dick Van Dyke.
Well, not anymore. The only thing you will be watching is Deep CNN. Now, I know you're used to loosey-goosey, but I run a much tighter ship. Between the hours of 3 p.m. and 7 p.m., I'm in charge. And when I'm in charge, you children will follow a schedule. And those who do not follow this schedule will be punished.
Punished?
Punished.
She's lying. She would never punish us.
Don't fuss with me, dear.
This is exploitation. It's not fair.
Oh, ooh. Shut up, Liddy.
Yeah, you got us into
oh,
this.
Oh, really?
Oh, my little ankle biters. Do I sense dissension in the ranks? Would you like to do some manual labor? Or are you ready to start your homework?
No, anything but this.
Then upstairs, my little nose miners. Go, flee before me. Expand your minds. Go bump some neurons. Oh, and I'll just prepare
Dad.
Something for your dinner.
I miss Dad.
Me too.
Me most.
I'm right here, guys. In some form. Okay, let's see. Dinner.
Down.
sewer smells like burnt rubber.
Oh, oh God! Oh dear! Oh no! Oh God! My first day as a woman, and I'm already getting hot flashes. I'll just order something for dinner. Those bloody kids won't know the difference. Yes, right. I'd like 4 special dinners, please, delivered to 2640 Steiner Street.
Yes.
Is dinner ready? We're ravenous.
Just 10 more minutes, dear. 10 minutes and you'll have the yummiest meal of your life.
Oh, God. Ryan, make it quick. Can't have Miranda finding this. Coming. God, it must be the food. Oh, right. You can just leave the food over there.
Here's your food, ma'am.
Sorry?
Here's your food.
Oh, right. How much will that be?
That would be
$135. $135? Jeez. Could you just hold that? There's 150. Keep the change.
Thank you. Disgusting old man.
Hello? Anyone home? Guys? There you are. God, for a second I thought I'd invited a serial killer onto my house. Where were you? What were you doing?
Upstairs, doing our homework.
Really?
Mrs. Doubtfire said we had to.
She did, huh?
Hi, Mom.
Hi, honey.
Dinner is served, madam.
Oh my goodness, wow.
Look.
This is amazing.
Look, I just wanted to apologize.
Apologize, dear? Oh, what for?
For being such a pain today.
Oh, it's quite all right, dear.
No, you see, I'm still kind of messed up about everything.
We all are, dear.
What?
We all are. Oh, I mean to say, I understand the pain that you're going through.
Yeah. I also wanted to thank you.
Thank me, dear.
For making my mom so happy.
Ooh.
She hasn't been happy in, well, it's been a really long time. I can't even remember.
Oh, dear. Well, I'm sorry to hear that, but thanks for letting me know. I should get back inside.
Thanks.
A book by its cover, or who you're gonna love by your lover. Say, love with me wise to her love in disguise. She had the body of a Venus, Lord. Imagine my surprise. She like it. Whoa, he was a lady.
Yeah, moving like a lady. Yeah, moving like a lady. Yeah, moving like a lady. Yeah, moving like a lady.
1 second.
Mrs. Hillard? Oh. Miranda, what are you doing home so early?
Well, I came home for lunch.
Oh. My, and who is your gentleman caller?
This is Stu.
Oh, hello, Stu.
He just wanted to come and meet the kids.
Oh, did he?
Yeah. Would you guys like some tea?
I'm all right.
Anything?
Tea, yes, tea would be lovely.
Are you going to make it or should I?
Oh, why don't you go make some tea for us, dear? I'll just have a little chat with Stu.
Well,
this must be the famous Mrs. Doubtfire. It's a pleasure to meet you.
You too, dear.
Well, Miranda's been raving about you.
What? She's never mentioned you.
No?
Nope, not once.
Well, that's odd.
Yes, odd.
Well, Mrs. Doubtfire, could I ask you a question?
Oh, ask away, dear.
Well, I have a home in London. I was born there. What part of England are you from exactly?
Oh, here and there, dear. All over, really.
Oh, well, your accent, it's like really muddled.
Oh, accent's muddled, eh? Oh, well, let's see here. Huh. So's your tan.
Ah, Mrs. Doubtfire.
Oh. Well, could you help me with something, dear?
Of course.
Right, I found this outside.
Hey, this is off my Mercedes.
Off your Mercedes, dear? You mean to say that big expensive car out there is yours?
Yes, it's mine.
Oh my, oh my. Well, you know what they say about people who have to buy big expensive cars like that.
Well, what do they say, Mrs. Doubtfire?
Well, Stu, they're compensating for smaller genitals.
Mrs. Doubtfire!
Oh, well, but that's not your case, is it, dear? I'm sure you're quite all right.
I'm going to go check on the car, thank you.
Stu.
Tea's ready.
Tea?
Where's Stu?
Oh, I don't know. He had to go check on his car or something. You know, these men. Never trust a man.
Yes, well, I suppose I'll see him at work. And speaking of that, Mrs. Doubtfire.
Yes, dear?
Would you mind staying a few extra hours this evening?
Staying longer? Certainly, dear. What is...
Stu and I wanted to go out for drinks.
Stu? Stu, you say?
Yes.
Stu. That's more of a thick soup than a name, dear.
It's a name. It's short for Stuart.
Is it?
Yes. He is a client. Well, and a friend. Well, he was a friend.
Well, what is it? You make up your mind.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, what seems to be the matter, dear?
Isn't he fabulous?
Yes, fabulous.
Well, he just wants to go out and have a few drinks. That's harmless.
Oh, no, Miranda, no. These men, they always have other intentions.
No, really, this is business. We're just going to go. I'll sip a club soda, and we're going over wallpapers.
But, Miranda, wake up and smell the coffee, dear. Can't you see the lust in that man's eyes?
Not really, no.
Oh, well, you've got to give your divorce time, dear. Let your sheets cool down before, you know.
Mrs. Doubtfire?
Yes, dear?
How long after Mr. Doubtfire?
Winston
passed away, did you feel any desire?
Oh, desire, never, never again, no. Once the father of your children is out of the picture, the only solution is total and lifelong celibacy.
Celibacy?
Celibacy, dear.
Are you sure?
Yes, and if you violate that, heaven forgive you.
Celibacy. You sure?
Well, you should get ready for work.
Yeah.
I think I'll just go and have a empty my bladder a little bit. Oh.
Oh, God. Celibacy. Right then.
Mrs. Doubtfire. Mrs. Doubtfire, where are you? I'm hungry, Mrs. Doubtfire. Where are you? Mrs. Doubtfire, I'll just use the washroom till then. Mrs. Doubtfire? Mrs. Doubtfire?
Oh, God!
Oh, God! Oh, God!
Oh, Krish!
Oh, God! Lady, where are you? Come quick!
Why?
We gotta call the cops. We gotta dial 911 now.
Why?
Mrs. Doubtfire, he's a she. She's a he.
What?
He's half man, half woman.
What?
Calm down, children.
Please, or you're gonna get it in the place where it hurts the most. Mr. Mrs. Whatever the hell you are.
Yeah. Wait, she's got him?
She's got everything.
Listen, children. I'm not who you think I am, okay?
Yeah, no shit. Hey, watch your language, young boy.
Dad?
Yeah, it's me.
Wait, you don't really like wearing this, do you?
Well, you know, I mean, some of it's comfortable, but... No. I do not like wearing this stuff, okay? It's not a way of life or anything. I don't go to old lady bars after work. No. This is just something I had to do.
Who?
So I could see you more often.
But who did this to you?
Oh, Uncle Frank.
Is it really you in there?
Well, yeah. This is a wig and, well, this is just a bodysuit.
It's good.
Thanks. Listen. You can't tell Mom about this, okay? For obvious reasons. And you can't tell Natty either, well, because she'll just blow our cover. Okay? So keep this a secret, all right?
Okay.
Come here, Chris.
Not yet, Dad. Oh. Not.
I get it. It's all right, Chris. It's all right.
I hope you understand.
Yeah. It's a guy thing. Right. Well, run after your classes, the two of you.
Bye, Dad.
Be good.
Goodbye, Dad.
Well, that was a close one. God. Who could that be?
Mrs. Selner, what are you doing here?
Who are you? And how do you know my name?
Well, nice. That's a very good question. Excellent question. Very astute. One that I'm about to answer right now. Well, now you see, I'm Daniel's sister. Daniel's sister, yes. Well, half-sister, technically.
Right.
You see, our father was a rather promiscuous man. Oh, God rest his soul, but... I was just here picking up some stuff with Daniel.
Right, well, can I see him?
Sydney, he's right upstairs, but... But I wouldn't go upstairs if I were you. You see, Miranda's not home right now. She will be home. But she's never home these days. And the new housekeeper hasn't been doing a very good job. Oh, so I've heard. Why don't you sit down right here? And I'll go call Daniel from upstairs.
Right.
Daniel! There's a Mrs. Selner here to see you.
Oh, all right. Mrs. Selner, I'll be down immediately. Right. Mrs. Selner, what are you doing here?
Yes, well, I had an appointment with Miranda, but
Miranda isn't home right now.
Yes, right. Well, then what are you doing here?
Well, what am I doing here? Right, I was just picking up some stuff. My sister's just accompanying me. We have permission and everything. Don't worry about it, Mrs. Selner.
Your...
Oh, my face. Oh, right. This is just something new I'm trying for a TV show I'm in.
Right, and the noise
The neighbors, kids, rowdy bunch. You should get going. You should get going. I'll let Miranda know you are in.
Oh, Lord.
God, I'm late. What is it now? Hello?
Miss Robinson?
Speaking.
Yes, I was just at your house for our appointment.
Oh, Mrs. Selner. Oh, my God. I am so sorry. I must have missed it by mistake.
Yes, well, that's a pity. We'll have to reschedule.
A real pity.
But while I was there, I did notice something rather peculiar.
Peculiar?
Yes. Mrs. Doubtfire and the kids were nowhere to be seen.
What?
And yet I ran into Daniel's British half-sister and his your ex-husband
what?
There.
Daniel doesn't even have a sister.
Make of it what you will, dear. I couldn't be bothered. Yes. Really.
I'll take it up with Daniel.
Yes. Now I have another appointment. Goodbye.
Goodbye. That lying piece of... Oh! Mrs. Doubtfire, are you home?
Oh, yes, dear, I'm home. Oh, one moment. Oh.
I'm in the kitchen.
Oh, what are you home again early for,
Where
Miranda?
Where were you?
Right.
I'm home early because I had an appointment with the court liaison.
Well, the kids and I just came back from the park, so, well, you must have just missed us.
Thank God.
And what are we saying with the court liaison?
Well, she came for her appointment, and I got worried because she told me none of you guys were here.
Ooh.
But Daniel and his older British half-sister were.
Oh, well, these court liaison social workers, you can never really trust them, can you?
He doesn't even have a sister.
Oh,
God.
My. Well, how could he replace you, dear? And so quickly.
Well, I wouldn't say replace. She's supposed to be older and very unattractive.
Oh, my. Unattractive. Oh,
Could you please help me?
Oh, certainly. What do you need help with, dear?
Just hold this. I need to put this in the fridge.
As I hold this cold meat, I'm reminded of Winston.
When did he, pass on?
Oh, 8 years ago, dear. This November.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Oh, don't be.
How did it happen?
Oh, well, he was rather fond of the drink.
And
in the end, it was the drink that killed him.
He was an alcoholic?
Oh, an alcoholic? Gosh, no, dear, not an alcoholic. Well, now you see, he was just walking down the streets one day, and then bam, hit by a Bacardi truck. His insides spilled all over the road. Quite a funny sight, really. You should have been there to see it. Well, you see, it was the drink that killed him.
How tragic. I'm so sorry for your loss.
It was really an amusing sight. I wish you were there.
Well, what was he like, you know?
Oh, Winston. Winston, a sainted man, a flawed husband, but a sainted man at heart. You know, I always say a flawed husband is better than no husband at all.
Well, who needs a husband when I've got you?
Well, surely you don't mean that, dear.
Well...
If I may ask, dear, what was so terrible about Daniel?
Well, you know, we were married for 14 years.
Well, yes. And what happened?
First, he was like the perfect guy. Ooh. He was smart and funny and spontaneous and... God, it was so nice.
Well, what happened, dear?
Well, you know, after a while, everything just stopped being funny. You know, because he was always between jobs. I was working all the time. I never got to see my kids. And, you know, when I could come home early to see them, the house would be a wreck. Everything would be a mess. And who would have to clean it up? Me.
Oh,
God,
well...
I was so tired of everything. And... The truth is, I didn't like who I was when I was with him. You know, I would turn into this awful, screaming person. And, you know, I don't want my kids growing up with a mom like that.
Oh, well, I'm sorry you had to go through that, dear. Well, it's all right, dear.
I never told him because Daniel, he never liked talking about anything serious.
Oh, well, you should have spoken to him about this, dear.
I used to think he could do anything. Except be serious.
Oh.
But I was serious enough for both of us, I guess.
Oh, well, you never know, dear. You.
Stu's going to be here any minute. Oh, and there he is.
Stu's coming again.
Yeah.
Oh, fantastic.
Hi.
Miranda, you look lovely today.
Oh, this old thing. Well, do come in. Make yourself at home.
Hello, Natalie. You must be Chris. Lydia, aren't you?
So guys, this is Stu, as you know.
Your tummy looks different from my daddy's.
Oh, we don't say that, dear. Not everyone can afford their own personal trainer.
And your daddy certainly couldn't.
Well, kids, I have a plan for you. How about we all go swimming.
Yes! That would be brilliant.
Okay then, come on, grab your swimsuit. Let's go.
You guys still have them, right?
Right. Stu. How old are you, Stu?
Well, I'm pushing 40.
40? And isn't it a bit weird to be dating Miranda at the moment?
Well, I don't want to spend the rest of my life by myself, do I?
Well, she's got 3 kids. That's a lot of baggage.
Oh, 3 terrific kids. And I'm crazy about them. Especially Natalie. Have you seen her? She's just a sweetie pie.
Well, yes, I'm quite aware.
Well, God knows they need a stable father figure in their life right now.
Well, what about their real father?
Well, what can I say? The guy's a loser. Well, take care for Mrs. Doubtfire.
Oh, just a little. We're so swimming, is it?
Well, why don't you go grab your swimsuit, Mrs. Doubtfire?
Oh, I couldn't possibly join you, dear. You go ahead, it's all right.
Oh, come on, Mrs. Doubtfire, don't be bashful.
Oh, isn't there enough flesh to feast your eyes on already?
Mrs. Doubtfire, come on.
Oh, I wish I could, dear, but they've outlawed whaling. We'd be reenacting the Titanic.
Well, if you're so insistent...
You go ahead, Stu, you go ahead. I'll just read a book or do something.
Kids,
ladies,
are you ready?
Do.
We're ready.
Ah, let's go then.
Mrs. Doubtfire, you're not coming?
Oh, no, you go ahead. You have fun with Stu.
Come on, guys, let's go.
Just not right for you. And you can tell me if I'm off, but I see it on your face when you say that he's the one that you want. And you spend all your time in this wrong situation, and anytime you wanted to stop,
I know I can treat you better than he can. And any girl like you deserves a gentleman. Tell me why I'll be wasting time.
Just had our first home-cooked meal.
This is terrific, Dad.
Thanks. Some more spaghetti?
No, I'm stuffed.
What about garlic bread? I made it myself.
Sure.
Well, I mean, I didn't cook it, but you know, I sliced it.
It's okay, Dad, thanks. The food's great, and the place, it just looks terrific. Oh. I'm really proud of you.
Me too.
Me too.
Oh, thanks, guys. Miranda?
Yep.
Oh, come on in.
Hi. Wow, I see you got someone to clean for you.
Clean for me? Oh, no. I did this all myself.
Oh, really?
Oh, yes. I cook, I clean, I bake, I sew, I do everything.
Really?
Oh, yes.
Are you guys ready to go?
Oh, well, we haven't had dessert yet, so just give us
some time.
There's
dessert?
Oh, yes. I do everything now. It's all thanks to this new DIY home course I'm taking.
Well, I'm very impressed.
Oh, thank you. But, well, the kids.
Well,
Miranda, why don't you give me another chance with the kids?
Daniel!
Please, let me take care of them.
I'll
take over for Mrs. Doubtfire.
Well, I can't get rid of Mrs. Doubtfire.
Well, why not?
She's part of the family. She's brilliant, you know? The house is always clean, the meals are always cooked. Everything is so nice. She helps the kids with their homework. Chris, he's passing in every single subject he failed in.
Oh, wow, Chris. I'm really proud of you.
So I can't let her go now. She's family.
Please, Miranda.
I'm sorry, Daniel. Come on, guys, let's go. Say goodbye to your dad.
This Mrs. Bye. Doubtfire, she really sounds too good to be true.
That's because she is.
Oh, well. Bye, kids. I'll see you next Saturday.
I didn't want you around. Those pretty faces always make you stand out in the crowd. But someone picked you from the bunch. One glance was all it took. Now it's much too late for me to take a second look. Oh, baby, give me one more chance.
Show your dad up,
won't you?
This night is so important for all of us. I mean, Stu, he's a good, stable, family man. He's every woman's dream.
So help me decide, red or black?
The red one.
Are you sure?
Red one.
Chris?
The black one. It's the most fun.
I don't know. Mrs. Doubtfire? Mrs. Doubtfire, are you all right?
Yes, dear. Sorry, I was just taking a little nap there.
Well, God knows you deserve it.
Right.
I need another woman's opinion. Black or red?
Well, what's the occasion?
It's my birthday.
Oh.
Stu's coming over for dinner.
Stu's coming, you say?
Yes.
Well, let's see. Black or red or... Stu, you say?
Yes.
Oh. Well, then neither.
Huh?
They're both too revealing, dear. They cry a harlot. And red. Red is the traditional color for streetwalkers. No. You can't wear that. You have to be like Mount Kilimanjaro on your first date. Completely inaccessible.
Well, it's not exactly our first date.
Let's see what else we have in your closet. Oh, my. It's... What about this lovely black frock? Classic, timeless, elegant. Oh, it's perfect, Miranda. Perfect.
It's old. I wore that to my aunt's funeral in 1976.
Oh, a classic never dies, dear. I think it's time to revive it.
I think I'd rather go to my own funeral than that. Kids, what do you think? Red, black, or funeral?
Definitely the short red one.
Red one?
Fine, Mom. The red one.
Then it's decided.
Well, if you're going to take my opinion and then not use it, don't blame me for what happens next.
How could I when you'll be there to protect me?
I'll be there to protect you, dear. Well, what do you mean?
Of course you're invited.
Oh,
it's my birthday. I can't have a birthday without you.
When is this enchanted evening, dear?
Friday, 7 o'clock.
This Friday?
Yes.
I couldn't possibly make it, dear. It's bingo night.
Oh, cancel it.
Oh, I couldn't possibly cancel bingo night. It's my turn to take the balls out of the little rotary thingy. Oh, Miranda, I wish I could be
no,
there.
No,
I
you have to ask someone else. I can't have a birthday without you, really. You're part of the family now. Please, don't make me have one without you. Come on, guys.
Part Mrs. of the Doubtfire, family?
You just have to. See, who could say no to this little fish?
All right, guys. I'll be there, okay?
Yes, thank you. Oh, this is going to be wonderful.
One big happy family.
Precisely. Oh, this is going to be so exciting.
Stu.
Do I attract you? Do I repulse you with my queasy smile? Am I too dirty? Am I too flirty? Do I like what you like? I could be wholesome, I could be loathsome. Guess I'm a little bit shy. Why don't you like me? Why don't you like me without making me try? I try to be like Grace Kelly, but all her looks with you sad. So I tried a little Freddy. I've got identity, man. Brown, I could be blue, I could be violet sky. I could be hurtful, I could be purple, I could be anything you like. Gotta be green, gotta be me, gotta be everything more. Why don't you like me, why don't you like me? Walk out the door. How can I help it, how can I help it, how can I help what you think? Hell of my baby, hell of my baby, putting my life on the brink. Why don't you like me? Why don't you like me? Why don't you like yourself? Should I bend over? Should I look older just to be put on your shelf? I try to be like Grace Kelly, but all her looks with you sad. So I tried a little Freddy. I've got identity, man.
I could be brown, I could be blue, I could be violet sky. I could be hurtful, I could be purple. Gotta be mean, gotta be everything more. Why don't you like me, why don't you like me? Walk out the door.
Say what you want to satisfy yourself.
Hey!
When you're alone,
could be violet sky. I could be hurtful. I could be purple. I could be anything you like. Gotta be green. Gotta be mean. Gotta be everything more. Why don't you like me? Why don't you like me? Walk out the door.
I could be brown. I could be blue. I could be violet sky. I could be hurtful. I could be purple.
Miranda, you look stunning.
But thank you.
Don't you think you should cover up a little?
I'm fine. And you look wonderful. Is that a new dress?
Oh, well, yes, it is.
Well, I made dinner. Come on, dig in.
Dinner, fabulous. Oh, drinks as well.
Yes.
My.
It's my 50th birthday.
Oh.
Well, Mrs. Doubtfire. You don't mind if I smoke, do you?
Oh, not at all, dear. Don't worry about it. In fact, I used to smoke myself. Oh, but that was a long time ago, dear. Nowadays, I find the best way to keep from smoking is to be around those who do smoke.
Well,
I just inhale a little bit now and then. And it really steals my wool.
Wow. Okay. But.
Excuse me, dear. I need to go take my medicines.
We have water at the table.
Oh, I can't take it orally, dear.
Huh? Well, would you like something to drink then, Mrs. Doubtfire?
Oh, how about a nice stiff Chardonnay? I like him light and woody.
Well, we don't have any of that.
Where's my medicines?
Well, what?
I suppose she's medicine. Upset about bingo.
Of course. These old ladies and their bingo. Well, why don't we start eating? Yeah. I have a gift for you, Miranda.
Oh, really? Oh, my goodness. It's beautiful. Thank you. Look at it.
I hope you like it.
My.
I love it.
Is it real?
Oh, it is very real, Mrs. Doubtfire. Very real.
Oh, my. Look at the size of that thing. You know what they say. You can either wear that or feed a small country.
I'll choose to wear it. Thank you.
Well.
Mommy, I gotta go. Now? Mrs. Doubtfire, could you take
No!
That?
You.
Oh, I think she wants you, dear.
I think I got that. Come on. We'll be right back.
Oh, kids, why don't you see what's there for dessert in the fridge? Before Stu here eats up all of it.
We'll be back.
Hurry on, then. Well, you might want to go a little easier on that.
How old are you, Stu?
Well, again, I'm 39.
Oh, I remember when I was your age. I was in my heyday. Oh, the gifts men would give me. Oh, my, oh, my. Well, a man gives a woman a gift like that. Oh. He wants more than a piece of her heart.
Oh, Mrs. Doubtfire, I promise it's not like that.
Oh, it's all right. You're men like you. I know men. Don't worry about
it. Oh, Mrs. Doubtfire, really? I do really like Miranda. It's not... Well...
I think I'll just go empty my bladder as well.
Ah.
Have fun.
Are you all right?
I think I'm all right. Don't worry.
Oh, she's had too much to drink.
Of course she has.
Well, you know how old ladies are.
The bottle's nearly empty.
Oh, my goodness.
Ah, well, we better just...
It was full. I bought it this morning.
That's incredible. Well, forget all of that. Let's just start eating.
Let's.
Ah, I'm back. Did I miss anything? Oh, Stu, are you all right there?
Are you all right? He's choking. Help!
Help is on the way, dear.
Help! Are you all right?
Oh, let me help you. Let me help you. Let's see. One, two, three.
Are you all right? Are you okay? What happened? Dad!
Well, yeah, I'm fine. Is that Daniel?
Daniel!
Happy birthday to you. Happy.
What?
Well, Miranda, now.
The whole time? The whole time?
Well, Miranda, listen, you have to let me explain.
Don't talk to
please,
me!
Please, Miranda, the kids!
Don't come near them out of my house now!
Please, Miranda.
I'll call the cops. So help me, get out! God, what is wrong with you? I'm sorry, I think it's quite obvious that dinner's cancelled.
Well, I better take my leave then.
Yeah. Come on, let's just go.
Without, I just need you now. Miss Robinson, do you have any closing remarks?
Nothing further, Your Honor.
Mr. Hillard, since you are determined to act as your own attorney, you are entitled to make a closing statement at this time.
Is there anything you have to say for yourself?
Your Honor, over these last 2 months, I have secured a residence, refurbished it, and made it an environment fit for children. Those are your words. And just yesterday, as you know, I landed a contract with Universal Studios to host the talk show Dynamic Mrs. Doubtfire. So I believe I have met your requirements. Ahead of schedule. Your Honor, you have to understand. I only did what I did so that I could be with my children. My children are everything to me, Your Honor. I cannot live without them. My children are like air to me. Like air, Your Honor. Just as one cannot live and breathe without air. I cannot breathe without my children by my side. It really isn't a request, Your Honor. I have to be with my children. I have to. There must be something you can do.
Mr. Hillard, you've been able to fool a lot of people into believing that you're a 60-year-old woman. Noisy task. And your little speech seemed to be very heartfelt and genuine.
It was.
But
it was, Your Honor.
I believe it to be a terrific performance from a very gifted actor. Nothing more.
No, Your Honor, it's not that. It really isn't that.
The reality, Mr. Hillard, is that your lifestyle over the past month has been very unorthodox. And I refuse to further subject 3 innocent children into your peculiar and potentially harmful behavior. It is the court's ruling to award full custody to Mrs. Hillard.
No, Your Honor, no.
Mr. Hillard, you will have supervised visitation rights every Saturday.
Supervised? Supervised, Your Honor, supervised?
A court liaison will accompany you when you spend time with the children. I'm suggesting a period of psychological testing and perhaps treatment for you. We will re-examine this case 1 year from now. Thank you. The court is adjourned.
I don't do laundry, I don't do windows, I don't do carpets, I don't do bathtubs, I don't do toilets, and I do not do diapers. Bad girl.
Natalie. Well, they're obviously not old enough to be well behaved. They are all potty trained.
Well, I don't do washing, I don't do cleaning, I don't do dinners, and I do not do reading.
So what do you do? I'm sorry, I'm on edge. I'll get back to you with the results of your application, and let me show you to the door. This was not very nice. What did you think? Oh, come on, please don't look so depressed. We'll find someone, I promise.
I miss her spaghetti. I miss her jokes.
I miss her stories.
Okay, I'll admit, things were nice when she was around because, well, you know, everything was perfect and warm and cozy and... Why are we talking about her like she's real? She's not real. She never was. She was a figment of some lunatic's imagination. Look, why don't you just get back to your work? Take your minds off this. We need to forget about her.
Miranda?
Hi.
Hi.
What
are you doing here?
I wanted to talk to you.
About what?
First of all, congratulations on the show.
Oh, thanks. Listen, the kids and you, you've got to come see the rehearsals.
We've been watching every day.
Oh, well, it's nice to know that they can see me in some form.
Daniel, look, I know it's going to take a long time to get over what we did to each other and the horrible things we said, but you and I are going to get over it, and I don't want to hurt our kids. Please.
What do you want me to do, Miranda? What do you want me to do? You sat there and smiled while that judge passed that despicable sentence. I can't see my children without supervision now.
I was angry.
Miranda, the court liaison watches me. Watches me without the kids and wonders why I want to hug them. Like I'm some sort of deviant. Jeez, Miranda. What do you want me to say? What do you want me to do?
Well, you hurt me too.
You ripped my heart out, Miranda.
I can't do this anymore, okay? I can't. I'm sick and tired of constantly trying to get back at each other. So would you just please listen to me for once in your life? Listen.
Go on.
Look, one thing I know is that the kids' lives were better with Mrs. Doubtfire in them. She brought out the best in them and she brought out the best in you.
And she brought out the best in you too.
And Daniel, the kids need you.
Miranda. Miranda, I need them.
So let's go. Someone new is coming today. I think you guys will really like them. That must be her. Want to go see who's at the door?
No.
Mr. Sprinkles, boys and girls. I've got a surprise for you.
Come in. Come on, guys. Get up. Let's go.
Come in.
Dad? What's going on?
Hi, kids. It's me.
Your dad's going to take you for a few hours after school every day.
What about the courts, that legal stuff?
Oh, ask your mother.
I took care of it.
No more supervised visits?
No more court liaison.
Just us? Just us.
Go pack your things.
Don't forget Mr. Bear.
This world that I found is too good to be true. Standing here beside you, want so much to give you this love in my heart that I'm feeling for you.
Let them say we're crazy, I don't care about that. Put your hand in my hand, baby, don't ever look back. Let the world around us just fall. Just fall apart.
All right. I'm on a tight schedule. Let's get this over with. Lights. Not on me, on him. Camera. Sound, please.
The letter.
I don't get paid enough for this. Do you want anything else? All right. Lights. Camera rolling. Sound. Action.
Dear Mrs. Doubtfire, 2 months ago, my mom and my dad decided to separate. Now, they live in different houses. My brother Andrew says we aren't a real family anymore. Did I lose my family? Is there anything I could do to get my parents back together? Sincerely, Katie McCormick. Oh, my dear Katie. You know, some parents get along much better when they don't live together. They don't fight all the time, and they can become better parents, better mummies and daddies for you. And sometimes they get back together, and sometimes they don't. But if they don't blame yourself, dear. Some children, some families have one mommy. Some families have two daddies. Some children live with their uncle or their aunt. Some children live with their grandparents. And some live with foster parents. But there is always family. For where there is love, where there is a home, there is a family. Some families don't see each other for days, weeks, months, or years. But where there is love, I repeat, where there is love, you have a family, dear Katie. All love to you. Bye-bye.
And see.
Gentlemen, now for our signature curtain call, right here in the Lorna Roberts Hall.
Doubtfire was so much fun.
I'm sure all of you will agree with me that she was not only dynamic, but also adorable and dashing. Once again, a huge round of applause for our wonderful performers. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together once again for an extraordinary performance as witnessed this evening. It was truly a spectacular show. All of this would have not been possible without the support, the unstinted efforts of all those who are present among us over here. Our special thanks to our governing body members who are present with us this evening today. May I now request our principal, Mr. Edwin, to kindly felicitate them.
May I request governing body member, Wing Commander Wilson, to please come forward. Mrs. Lily White for gracing this occasion. Thank you, ma'am. And Mrs. De Cruz for always encouraging our children. Thank you, ma'am. Our special thanks and gratitude to all the heads of our sister institutions who are present here today. Mr. Julian Luke, principal of the Bishop's Co-Ed School, Undri. Mr. Shane McPherson, principal of the Bishop's Co-Ed School, Kalyananagar. Thank you, sir. A big thank you to all our backstage crew, led by Arnav Dev. May I request Arnav to please come forward and collect their goodies. Thank you, dear stage crew. The photography team, led by E.L. Packer and Dhruv Sanghvi. Anyone of you present here? Here. The video editing done by Sukriti Mehta and Jaden Lazarus. Thank you. The presentation and the BTS video for Dipansh Chopra and Aditya Singh. Thank you. Our carpenters, Mr. Jagtap and Mr. Dubey, thank you for helping us in getting this wonderful stage ready. The electrician and lights handled by Subhash Mogle. Mr. Sachin Veer and Manoj Khadge for helping us with the lights.
Mr. Pemba Sherpa for all his support and contribution with the design and invites, posters, and the wonderful certificates that he's designed for us. Mr. Pemba Sherpa. Mrs. Sonam Barton and her team for the visuals on the screen and the attractive presentations. Thank you, ma'am. This is Anita Parekh for her inputs and supervision of the dances. The one-man team, Mr. Yogesh Khadge, for the spectacular sets and props, which he single-handedly designs to perfection. Thank you, sir. Mr. AJ Eats, who ensured that we had wonderful audio during the whole show. Rachel Thomas, whose musical expertise and guidance ensured that our children gave the best performances. Ladies and gentlemen, our scriptwriter and director, Mrs. Gulnar Mistry. Who worked tirelessly to ensure that the best of the children's performances were good. For our Man Friday, Mr. John, for helping us with everything that we required, Mr. John. Ladies and gentlemen, would not have been possible without our principal, Mr. Joel Edwin. I would like to request Mrs. De Cruz to please come forward for all his unstinted guidance, support, and supervision, without which a presentation of this stature was just not possible. Thank you, sir.
I'm sorry to disturb, but I think so this entire project could not have been possible without them.
So can we please have a massive round of applause for our dean, Ms. Madhuhara. Thank you so much, ma'am, for everything that you do for us. And as all good things come to an end,
I hope this evening has left everyone with a smile on their faces. And as you head back home, I hope that you remember this night for quite some time. So now, I'd like to request all of you to please kindly stand up for the school song for the national anthem.
And we just get one of our governing body members to just say a few words before we dismiss. Mrs. Lily White, if you can just come and share a few words, please.
There are just no words to express what we've all felt this evening. I think everyone, there's no doubt about it, is it? Mrs. Doubtfire was just outstanding. You are just super. Too good. I normally don't pick out an actor, but I think it would be unfair if I did not say the stage was yours, man. Totally yours. You know, the main thing that struck me is that these children that took part today are standard 11 and 12. Some of them we just had, say, for the last year. Some of them have just joined. I mean, some of them don't even know each other. I think you all have just met over these last practices or got to know each other. But the bonding you could see was fantastic. I mean, to put up something like this, to have people dance, smile, act, and, you know their words. There wasn't a prompter here in front, if you notice. The children went through smoothly. There was no hesitation anywhere, whether it was a dance, whether it was their words or their singing or whatever. Kudos to you, Rachel, with your team of the choir. You really surprised us, because whether it's the junior school, the middle school, the senior school, Bishop School has just a fantastic set of singers. You are just amazing, amazing. I liked all those individual voices. But, you know, I must tell you, to put on something like this, I've been a school teacher for 40 years myself. And there's a lot of work. There's a lot of people behind the scenes that I never thanked, or nobody even realizes how hard they've worked. Sometimes it's the smallest jobs that they've done that have counted the most for us. The audience, I'm so glad that I can see such a young audience over here. Obviously, you've kept your mums and dads at home and decided. I learned that from an ex-student who phoned me and wanted to know if I was attending. And he said his son was attending, but they were not. So you can see what had happened. They got all their friends to come and told mom and dad to stay at home. But mom and dad have missed something, I must say. They should have been here. And to appreciate what we saw today here there and everywhere. Sound, the lighting, the stage, what else? The foods you all have been having, Mrs. Vora, I'm sure, you know, it's been a tough task. But the lady who I, as I told Mr. Edwin, I'll never miss her place for anything, is my dear Mrs. Mystery. She is super. Very honestly, I thought I was never going to make this because I've not been well, but you are just amazing. You are amazing. Whether it's Christmas or whether it's any other time of the year, I've somehow or the other felt, you know, you've got to come down to Bishop's and see their concerts, no matter what it is. And I thought I was never going to make it for this, but as I told Mr. Edwin, I won't miss Mrs. Mystery's show for anything. But all said and done, this is the quality that is available at all our schools. And that's what you must see. The next round, I suppose, will be Undri and KLN. But every one of their plays, whether it's junior school, middle school, KG, or the senior school, hats off to you, Bishops. You are absolutely thorough. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I really feel the proudest principal in the whole wide world right now. So this is the fourth stage production that we've had during the academic year. And there's one more to come in the month of November. So you can just imagine the amount of talent that we have right through the schools in all the sections. So once again, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for being here this evening. I do hope you've enjoyed yourself. Thank you for all your love and support to our children and bring them in for all the practices. Have a good evening. God bless each one of you. I'll request all those who are part of the production to come on stage, please, immediately. Mr. Yahadge, Mrs. Parikh, Ms. Thomas, AJ, if you can come up, please. We'll just have a good photograph with everyone. Children, get together. Don't leave Mrs. Doubtfire out somewhere. Put her in the middle.